This video we are going to see some examples on limits and continuity. Let's look at the first problem. The first problem asks, show that the limit xy approaches 0, 0, 2x cube plus y cube over xy square does not exist. Okay. Now here you can see when we apply this 0, 0, we will get 0 over 0 situation, right? So we have to do something else. Let's copy this limit down. Limit x, y approaches 0, 0. And the function given is 2x cube plus y cube over xy square, okay? And from this one you can see when we plug 0, the top and bottom are going to be 0, 0, 0. So we cannot determine doing that way, right? So we have to do something else. So here what we can do is, we can take limit x approaches 0, and instead of y we can plug equation of the line and see whether it works. If it doesn't work, we can go for the equation of parabola and we can go like that, right? So let's go ahead and see whether it works. So 2x cube instead of y cube, I'm going to put equation of the line, that's mx, right? Mx cube divided by x times instead of y square, we are going to put mx whole square. So now everything in terms of x, that's why we don't have y, that's why we only take x is x approaches 0. Now let's see whether we can simplify this one. And here we can take x square outside. So we are going to have m square. Let's simplify. Okay, this is going to be limit x approaches 0. Then we are going to have, if we take x cube common, this is going to become 2 plus m cube divided by mx cube, right? From this one we can see this x cube and x cube cancels. Now we have this one, and this is limit x approaches 0. We have 2 plus m cube over m. So from this one we know that limit does not exist because this limit is depending on m. For example, if you pick up value, if you pick up 1 for m, and if you plug it in this equation, and okay, before I do that, I had put a square right here because I missed it. Okay, this one should be square. So to check whether the limit exists or not, you can, because since this is not dependent on x, x is not going to make any effect, right? So we can pick any value for m. For example, if we pick 1 for m, this is going to be 3 divided by 1, and we will get 3 if we plug 1. And if you plug negative 1, you will get a different answer because we are going to have 2 plus negative 1, that's going to become 1 divided by, so negative 1 is going to be 1, 1 divided by negative 1, that's going to give us negative 1. So we are getting different answer. This means that limit does not exist. Okay, limit does not exist. So this is the answer for the first one. Now let's look at the second question. The second question is asking, determine whether the f of xy is equal to xy over square root of x square plus y square if xy not equal to 0, 0, 0 if xy 0, 0. Okay, they're asking to prove whether it is continued at 0, 0, justify your answer. So here all we have to do is just take the limit approach 0, 0 and see whether we get a limit value. If the limit does not exist, it means it's not continuous. If the limit exists, it's continuous, okay? So this is going to be xy approaches 0, 0, and the function given is xy over square root of x square plus y square. And whenever you see x square plus y square, you can try to convert this one into polar coordinate pattern, okay? Now let's get rid of this part. We have done the first part. Let's get rid of this and continue here. So here we go, I'm going to switch this one into polar coordinate. If I switch this one into polar coordinate, this xy approaches 0, 0 becomes limit r approaches 0. Okay, limit r approaches 0, and instead of x we plug r cos theta, and instead of y we plug r sine theta, and in the denominator we are going to have square root of r cos theta square, r cos theta whole square, and then plus r sine theta whole square, and here we can take r square common. If we do that, that's going to become limit r. So if we take r square common, and also we can take the r outside, so we are going to have r outside. Okay, let's do the top part first. Top part is going to be r square cos theta sine theta. In the denominator, we are going to have, we can take a r square common, because you can see r square cos square theta, r square sine square theta, sine square theta. So we can take r square common, and if we take the r square outside of the square root, that's going to become r. And inside of the square root, we are going to have cos square theta plus sine square theta. And from trig identity, you know this is going to be equal to 1, right? So this value is going to be equal to 1. Therefore, this is, we can just get rid of this one, because this is just 1. So we don't have to worry about this one. And from this one, we can see this one cancels. And if you plug, this is approaching 0. If you plug r is equal to 0, then the whole thing is going to be 0. So we get a limit that's equal to 0. Since the limit exists, this is continuous at 0, 0. And that's how we do this kind of problems. I hope this helps. Thanks for watching.